Good morning, brothers and sisters.
Good morning.
What a joy it is to worship together in person and online this morning, this Lord's Day.
And
what a beautiful Lord's Day it is. God is good. And we worship Him. Today we'll be wrapping up our study of 1 Thessalonians.
今天我们要把帖撒罗尼迦前书的学习来完成。
This has been a very rich and practical study for us.
这是一个很丰富又很实际的学习。
We were able to see the example of the Thessalonian church.
我们可以看到
We saw their tremendous growth in the Lord. Even in the midst of tribulation.
We saw
how they turned to the living God from idols. How they received the word from Paul and his team as it was, as the word of God, and that word changed their lives.
We've
seen how they become imitators of Paul and his team and of the Lord. How they became examples to all the churches. In their work of faith, their labor of love, and their steadfastness of love.
这是因为他们信心所做的功夫, 爱心所受的劳苦, 还有为基督所存的忍耐, 盼望。
Actually, it was steadfastness of hope. Just testing you.
因为忍耐所存的盼望。
And how they thoroughly and accurately proclaim the word of God, not only in their province of Macedonia, but in the neighboring province of Achaia as well.
他们怎样的像不只是在帖撒罗尼迦还有像马其顿、雅该亚他们也传扬把神全备的福音传扬出来。
So that Paul said, we don't need to go and add anything or correct anything.
所以保罗说我们不必我们再说什么。
We saw how Paul defended his ministry and how he described how to effectively build the church of God.
我们也看到保罗, 如何是, 为自己的工作做辩护。
The model that he gave us to build the church as a loving mother, as a committed father.
他用比喻来说, 我们怎样建造教会, 像一个慈爱的母亲, 也像一个 父亲,
leaving a good model for us to follow.
也为我们留下一个好的榜样,
we saw how Paul was concerned about the church in the midst of tribulation and persecution that they might fall from the faith.
我们也看到保罗怎样, 因为教会在逼迫当中, 保罗有这样的担心, 怕他们离弃了信仰。
And how he sent Timothy to encourage them.
所以他派提摩太去鼓励他们。
But Timothy came back greatly encouraged by them.
那提摩太回来反而被他们大大的鼓励。
He was encouraged by news of their faith and their love.
因为提摩太被帖撒罗尼迦教会的他们的爱心和信心所鼓励。
He was encouraged that they were standing firm in the Lord.
他见到他们在主里面站立得稳而受鼓励。
And we saw how Paul encourage them to excel still more.
我们也看到保罗怎样鼓励他们继续的努力。
To walk in a way that pleases God in holiness and sanctification.
鼓励他们怎样在主里成圣，走圣洁的道路。
In the power of the Holy Spirit.
是借着圣灵的力量。
This is just a simple summary.
这就是个简短的总结。
And now Paul is working on closing this important letter to the Thessalonians.
那现在保罗要结束这封给帖撒罗尼迦教会的重要的书信。
And he concludes his message with this powerful message of hope and direction for Christian living.
他结束这封书信是以这样一个强有力的信息，就是生活的基督徒生活的盼望还有指引。
And that's what we're going to be talking about today.
这是我们今天要讲的。
The message that Paul gives for hope and direction for Christian living.
保罗所讲的就是基督徒生活的盼望和指引。
Now try to make it simple, help us understand, and remember, I'm going to be calling this a handbook for Christian living.
为了把这个信息简化，并且让我们能够记住，能够活出来，我把这个信息叫做基督徒生活手册。
And there are two parts of this handbook for Christian living.
那这生活手册可以分成两个部分。
The first part is hope.For living.
那第一部分是生活的盼望。
And as Brother Zhong Dao was sharing on chapter 4, he recommended that we actually bring the last section of chapter 4 together with chapter 5. And so that's what we're doing today.
像钟道弟兄谈到的，我们把第四章的最后一节和第五章合在一起，因为信息是连贯。
So the hope for living, there are two sections. One is the coming of the Lord.
那生活的盼望又分两个部分，第一部分是主的降临。
From chapter 4, verses 13 through 18.
是第四章十三到十八节。
And secondly is the day of the Lord.
那第二部分是主的日子。
Chapter 5, 1 through 11.
五章一到十一节。
But this handbook of Christian living doesn't just give us hope for living, it also gives us directions for living.
这基督徒生活手册不只给我们生活的盼望，也给我们生活的指引。
It particularly gives us directions for godly relationships in the Church of Christ.
特别的是给了我们在基督教会中近前关系的指引。
Before we start, let's first read this first section from 1 Thessalonians 4, verses 13, all the way through 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 11.
开始之前先把第一部分读一下。
So, Daishin, would you start with Chinese?
论到睡了的人，我们不愿意弟兄们不知道，恐怕你们受伤，像那些没有指望的人一样。我们若信耶稣死而复活了，那已经在耶稣里睡了的人，神也必将他与耶稣一同带来。我们现在照主的话告诉你们一件事，我们这活着还存留到主降临的人，断不能在那已经睡了的人之先。
Brothers, we do not want you to be ignorant about those who fall asleep. Yeah, join together. Let's start again. Brothers, we do not want you to be ignorant about those who fall asleep or to grieve like the rest of men who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and so we believe that God will bring with Jesus those who have fallen asleep in him.According to the Lord's own word, we tell you that we who are still alive, who are left till the coming of the Lord, will certainly not precede those who have fallen asleep.
因为主必亲自从天降临，有呼叫的声音和天使长的声音，又有神的号吹响。那在基督里死了的人必先复活，以后我们这活着还存留的人必和他们一同被提到云里，在空中与主相遇，这样我们就要和主永远同在。所以你们当用这些话彼此劝慰。
Verse 16 together. For the Lord himself will come down from heaven with a loud command, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet call of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first.After that, we who are still alive and are left will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage each other with these words. Let's continue on in chapter 5.
弟兄们，论到时候日期，不用写信给你们。因为你们自己明明晓得主的日子来到，好像夜间的贼一样。人正说平安稳妥的时候，灾祸忽然临到他们，如同产难临到怀胎的妇人一样，他们绝不能逃脱。弟兄们，你们却不在黑暗里，叫那日子临到你们像贼一样。你们都是光明之子，都是白昼之子。我们不是属黑夜的，也不是属幽暗的。
Verse 1, now brothers, about times and dates, we do not need to write to you, for you know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. While people are saying peace and safety, destruction will come on them suddenly as labor pains on a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. But you, brothers, are not in darkness so that this day should surprise you like a thief. You are all sons of light and sons of day. We do not belong to the night or to the darkness.
所以我们不要睡觉，像别人一样。 总要警醒谨守，因为睡了的人是在夜间睡，醉了的人是在夜间醉。但我们既然属乎白昼，就当应当谨守，把信和爱当作护心镜遮胸，把得救的盼望当作头盔戴上。因为神不是预定我们受刑，乃是预定我们借着我们主耶稣基督得救。
So then, let us not be like others who are asleep, but let us be alert and self-controlled. For those who sleep, sleep at night. Those who get drunk at night. But since we belong to the day, let us be self-controlled, putting on faith and love as a breastplate, and the hope of salvation as a helmet. For God did not appoint us to suffer wrath, but to receive salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ.
他替我们死，叫我们无论醒着睡着都与他同活，所以我们该彼此劝慰，互相建立，正如你们素常所行的。He
died for us so that whether we are awake or asleep, we may live together with him. Therefore, encourage one another and build each other up. Let's pray. Lord, we do thank you for your word. We thank you for this very encouraging message of hope and direction for our lives. And we pray that you will open our eyes to see wonderful things from your word.
主，求你开我们的眼睛，让我们看到你话语中的奇妙。
That you will open our ears to hear the words that you have for us today.
求你开我们的耳朵，让我们能听到你要对我们讲的话语。
That you will give us the grace to understand and to apply your words in our lives.
赐给我们恩典，让我们能够明白，并且把你的话应用出来。
We pray this all in the wonderful name of Jesus.
这样祷告是奉耶稣奇妙的名。Amen.
So in this section, Paul goes into great detail on teaching of the end times.
在这里，保罗讲到关于末世的一些细节。But
I think it's important to remember that this is not intended as a systematic theology textbook on the end times.
就是我们要记得，这里并不是关于末世的一个系统神学的。
Paul's intent here is pastoral.
保罗在这里是作为一个牧师来牧养。
It's to encourage and build up the brothers and sisters.
是来鼓励并且建造弟兄姐妹。
In fact, at the end of both of these sections, there's a phrase, therefore encourage one another.
所以在这部分最后都是说，所以你们该彼此劝勉。
Therefore encourage one another and build each other up with these words.
所以要彼此劝勉，互相建立。I
think we need to remember that the epistles weren't pre-prepared lesson plans.
所以我们要记得，保罗的书信，这些使徒的书信，并不是事先预备好的这样的一个讲章。The
epistles weren't canned curriculum.
这使徒书信并不是好像准备好的这样的教材。
They were practical answers to current issues, real issues that the believers were facing.
它是很实际的，对于当时信徒正在面临的各样的挑战问题的一个回应。
And they were written to meet real needs.
他们写出来是要针对他们信徒当时真正的需要。
So this is what Paul is doing in this passage.
这就是正是保罗在这封书信里所做的。
We shouldn't treat it as a theological dissertation on end times.
这并不是一个对于末世的一个单纯神学上的讨论。
But it's something that's written to encourage us and lift us up.
这是写出来是要鼓励我们，来建造我们。
One of the things that I was reminded of as I was preparing is that an important aspect in the early church.
那我在准备信息的时候，我就看到这一点，就是在早期教会的时候，这一点是非常重要的。
An important aspect of teaching.To the early first century believers.
这个对于第一世纪的早期的教会的信徒，对他们很重要的一个方面。
Was that Jesus Christ is coming soon?
那就是耶稣基督快要再来了。
To establish his kingdom and to take his people with him forever.
要建立他的国度，要把他的子民，跟他的子民同在。
The coming of Christ was taught as something that's imminent.
那主的降临是被在这里教导是随时可能
发生的。It could happen at any moment.
可能任何时候都可能发生。
And there was this sense of expectation, this sense of anticipation, this sense of excitement that Jesus is coming back.
所以在信徒中有这样一种一种紧急感，有这样一种他们有这样一种期待，有这样一种激动，说因为耶稣快要回来了。
And the believers in Thessalonica knew that.
那帖撒罗尼迦教会的信徒们，他们知道这一点。
In chapter 5, verse 1, Paul says, "About times and dates, we do not need to write you."
所以保罗在第五章开头说：“弟兄们，论到时候、日期，不用写信给你们。”
You know this very well.
因为你们自己明明知道。
They knew that Christ would return, and that His return was the climactic event of redemption history.
那他们知道耶稣要回来，而且耶稣的再来是整个神救赎计划的高潮。
They were excited about it. They anticipated it.
他们对这件事非常的激动，他们盼望着这个。
And they didn't want to miss it.
他们不想错过这个。
But some of their fellow believers had already died, and Jesus hadn't come back yet.
所以，但是他们有的信徒，他们的朋友已经过世了，已经死了。那可是耶稣还没有回来。
And they were concerned about these brothers and sisters who died. Would they miss the rapture?
所以他们对这点，就有担心，说他们是不是错过了。
And so this first section that we're looking at today in chapter 4, verses 13 through 18, Paul is directly answering that question, that concern.
所以在这里面的第一段，第四章十三到十八节，保罗是特别针对他们这样的疑问来回答。
So the first part of our handbook for Christian living is hope for living, and we're looking at the coming of the Lord.
那在我们称为基督徒生活手册的第一部分《生活的盼望》里，那第一小部分我们看到主的降临。
Paul starts out in verse 13 with two things that he wanted to remind the believers of.
那第十三节，保罗提醒信徒们两件事。
Two things that he wants to remind us of.
这两件事也是我们要被提醒的。
First is that we do not want you to be ignorant about those who fall asleep.
那第一个就是论到那些睡了的人，我们不愿意你们不知道。
Those who fall asleep is a metaphor for physical death.
那这里说到睡了的人是指肉体的死亡。
We don't want you to be ignorant about that, but we do not want you to grieve like the rest of men who have no hope.
我们不愿你们不知道，也不愿你们忧伤，像那些没有指望的人。
Now, as believers, when a loved one dies, we do mourn, we do grieve.
作为信徒，当我们所爱的人过世的时候，我们当然是忧伤。
That's part about how God created us to deal with the trauma of losing a loved one.
那这神造我们是这样，我们失去所爱的人啊，我们是心灵会受伤。
That's part about how God created us to bring healing and restoration after the trauma of a lost one.
这是神造我们是这样，我们失去所爱的人，我们要我们要恢复，要得到医治，是需要经过这样的阶段。
But there's a sharp contrast between how a believer grieves and mourns and how an unbeliever grieves and
但是信徒和非信徒他们的这样的忧伤有一个很鲜明的对比。
Unbelievers have no hope.
不信的人他们没有盼望。
We have hope.
我们有盼望。
We have a firm assurance that our loved ones are with the Lord in His presence.
我们有这样一个确信，知道我们所爱的人是与主同在。
They will be with Him forever.
他们要与主永远同在。
So what about those who have already died in the Lord?
那论到这些，这是已经在主里睡了的人怎么样呢？
Paul has three facts for the Thessalonian Christians and for us.
那保罗对帖撒罗尼迦的信徒也是对我们有三点要说的。
First is that God will bring with Jesus those who have fallen asleep in him.
那第一个是，那已经在耶稣里睡了的人，神必将他与耶稣一同带来。
They're with Jesus, and when Jesus returns again, God will bring with Jesus those loved ones.
他们与主同在，当耶稣再来的时候，神就将他们与耶稣一同带来。
Secondly, from verse 16,
talks about
that the dead in Christ will rise first.
那在基督里死了的人必先复活。
For the Lord himself will come down from heaven with a loud command.
因为主必亲自从天降临，有呼叫的声音。
With the voice of the archangel.
有天使长的声音。
With the trumpet call of God.
有神的号吹响。
And the dead in Christ will rise first.
那在基督里死了的人必先复活。
Brothers and sisters, don't worry about those who have already passed away. They will not miss that event.
所以弟兄姐妹们，不要为那些已经睡了的人担忧，他们是要先复活。
And then the third fact is that we will be with the Lord forever.
那第三点就是我们要与主同在，直到永远。
After the Lord comes and the dead in Christ rise first, after that we who are still alive will be caught up together with them.
那以后我们这活着存留的人必和他们一同被提到云里。
To meet the Lord in the air, and we will be with Him forever.
在空中与主相遇，这样我们就要和主永远同在。
This is a blessed hope.
这就是那荣耀的盼望。
I love the way Paul describes it in Titus chapter 2, verse 13.
我很喜欢保罗在提多书二章十三节所讲的。
While we wait for the blessed hope, the glorious appearing of our great God and Savior. Jesus Christ.
等候所盼望的福，并等候至大的神和我们救主耶稣基督的荣耀显现。
So Paul assures them that those who have already passed away in the Lord, they will be raised with him. They will experience this event, the rapture.
那保罗就提醒，说那些在主里先睡了的人，他们要先复活，然后，我们一同与主同在。他们不会错过被提。
And Paul continues his encouragement with the second section from chapter 5 verses 1 through 11.
那然后保罗就讲到生活盼望的第二个部分，是第五章一到十一节。
But there's a slight change of direction here.
这里有，有一点小小的变化。
In English it says now. The Greek says but.
那在英文是说现在，那希腊文是说但是。
That there's a shift in direction.
就在方向上有一个转换。
Says it presents even a greater contrast between believers and unbelievers.
所以这里就在信徒和不信的人之间就有一个更大的，更大的一个对比。
talks about the day of the Lord that the Thessalonian Christians know about very well.
就提到主的日子是帖撒罗尼迦信徒很清楚的事情。
And the day of the Lord is primarily presented in the Bible as a fearsome, terrifying judgment from God on wickedness.
那在圣经里提到主的日子是一个大而可畏的，是让人恐惧战惊的神审判的日子。
For example, just give a few examples, a few from the Old Testament and one from the New Testament.
就举几个例子，有旧约有新约的。
In Joel chapter 1 verse 15.
在约珥书
says, alas, for that day, the day of the Lord is near. It will come like destruction from the Almighty.
那约珥书里面讲到说，说看了主的日子，全能神的日子要来到，它是毁灭的日子。
In chapter 2 of Joel, verse 11, the second part, it says, the day of the Lord is great, it is dreadful, who can endure it?
约珥书二章十一节提到说，主的日子是大而可畏，谁能站立得住呢？
Zephaniah, chapter 1, verses 14 and 15.
西番雅书第
chapter 1, 14 and 15.
14和15。
The great day of the Lord is near.
那神的大而可畏的日子近了。
It's near and coming quickly.
靠近了，马上就到了。
Listen, cry on the day of the Lord will be bitter.
你们听啊，要哭泣，因为那日是带来苦难的。
That day will be a day of wrath.
那是一个神震怒的日子。
A day of distress.
是让人忧伤恐惧的日子。
A day of anguish.
是痛苦的日子。
A day of trouble and ruin.
是大大的恐惧，是毁灭的日子。
A day of darkness and gloom.
是大大的幽暗黑暗的日子。
The day of the Lord is presented as a fearsome, terrifying judgment.From the Lord on the unbelievers, on the wicked.
那主的日子在这里描述是一个让人恐惧、战惊、审判的日子。
In the New Testament, one verse I want to share is 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 10.
那在新约里面有一节要跟大家分享是彼得后书。
But the day of the Lord will come like a thief. The heavens will disappear with a roar. The elements will be destroyed by fire. And the earth...And everything in it will be laid bare.
是彼得后书
Chapter 3, verse 10.
彼得后书第几章？第三章，是说到主的日子来到，必有大响声，天地都要废去。
So Paul goes on to talk about the day of the Lord, shares several very important facts.
那保罗讲到主的日子有几个重要的方面。
He says that the day of the Lord will be like a thief in the night. It will be like labor pains on a pregnant woman.
他说到像好像夜间的贼来到一样，又像产难临到怀胎的妇人。
He uses the metaphors of a thief.The labor pains on a pregnant woman, a metaphor of night and darkness.
所以它比喻是好像夜间一样，好像贼一样。
So what does this thought of a thief in the night convey?
那这种夜间还有贼是要传递怎么样的信息呢？
What does it convey to you?
你会让你想到什么呢？
I mean, it's something that's sudden. It's something that's unexpected.
是好像是很突然的，是你没有预料到的。
It comes without warning.
是没有预警的。
It's something that's actually unwanted.
是你不希望发生的。
It brings loss.
会带来损失。
It's a great metaphor.
是一个很好的一个比喻。
And then he talks about the labor pains of a pregnant woman.
然后又提到像妇人的生产一样。
What does that convey?
这让你想到什么？
The pregnant woman knows they're coming. It's inevitable.
那怀孕的妇人知道她生产要来到，是不可避免的。
I don't know this personally.
那我没有个人的经验。
But it's something that's also sudden. It's inescapable.
也是很突然的，也是你逃不掉的。
It's painful.
是痛苦的。
In the first part of verse 3, it says, While people are saying peace and safety, destruction will come on them suddenly.
那第三节说，人正说平安稳妥的时候，灾祸忽然临到他们。
But as believers, we have a new nature.
可是我们是信主的人，我们有一个新的有一个新的品性。
We're not like the others.
我们跟不信的人不一样。
We are sons of light and sons of day.
我们是光明之子，是白昼之子。
We don't belong to night or darkness.
我们不是属黑夜或幽暗的。
So we should not be like the others.
所以我们不应该像别人那样。
What are the others like, unbelievers?
那不信的人怎么样呢？
They are those who are asleep.
他们就好像睡觉的人。
In the previous section, we saw that sleep represented a physical death.
那上一章我们看到这个用睡来形容肉体的死亡。
Here, sleep more represents a spiritual separation.
这里这个睡是来形容一个属灵里的隔离。
Spiritual death.
属灵的灵上的死亡。
They're asleep.
他们是在睡觉的。
They're living in darkness.And night.
生活在黑夜里，生活在黑暗之中。
Uses a metaphor of drunkenness.
然后又用到这个醉酒的比喻。
Spiritually, they're like someone who is drunk and not in control of themselves.
那用从属灵上来讲，不信的人就好像是醉酒的人，他们没有不能够控制自己。
And they suffer God's wrath.
他们要面对神的愤怒。
But we're not like them.
但是我们不像他们。
We're different.
我们是不同的。
And because of that, we need to be alert and self-controlled.
所以正因如此，我们要警醒谨守。
We need to be ready and prepared.
我们要预备好。
Paul uses the example of a battle.
那保罗用到一个打仗的比喻。
We need to put on armor and fight the battle.
我们要戴上头盔来征战。
Says that we need to put on the breastplate of love and faith.
我们要戴上爱心和信心的这个盾牌。
Says that we need to put on the hope of salvation like a helmet.
我们要把得救的盼望像头盔一样戴上。
And fight the good fight of the faith in the world of darkness.
我们要在这个黑暗之中打那美好的仗。
Because we are sons of light, sons of the day.
因为我们是光明之子，是白昼之子。
We don't belong to night or darkness.
我们不是属黑夜或幽暗的。
We need to be alert, self-controlled, ready and prepared.
所以我们要警醒、谨守、预备好。
So God did not appoint us to receive wrath, but He appointed us to receive salvation through Jesus Christ.
因为神是预定我们在主耶稣基督里得救，不是预定我们受刑。
Now we hear, as we listen to how the early church anticipated the coming of the Lord.
那我们这里看到早期的教会他们是怎样来盼望主的再来。
How earnestly they were expecting Jesus's coming at any moment.
他们如何热切地盼望主耶稣。随时可以回来。
I think one of the great tragedies of modern Christianity.
那这是我想是当代基督信仰的一个悲剧。
Is that many of us have become complacent?
我们就变得麻木。
We've lost the wonder.
我们失去了这样一个敬畏。
We've lost the earnest expectation.
我们失去了这样一个热烈的盼望期望。
We've lost the passionate anticipation for the Lord's coming.
我们失去了这样一个充满激情的期待主再来的。
The Lord is still coming soon.
主会再来。
We need to regain that excitement, that anticipation.
我们要重新我们要把这种热切的盼望重新拿回来。
Regain that sense of expectation.
这样一种期待的，这样一种热切的期待。
So that we will be alert and self-controlled and ready when he comes.
这样我们就可以 警醒，我们就可以谨守，我们可以随时预备好。
Can I hear an amen?
你能听到大家说阿们吗？
Actually, Peter in 2 Peter chapter 3 talks about the end times.
那实际上彼得在彼得后书也讲到末世。
In verses 3 and 4 it says, in the last days, scoffers will come, scoffing and following their own evil desires.
那彼得说在末世的时候必有好讥诮的人，随从他们的好讥诮的心。
They will say, where is the coming that he promised?
他就会说主所应许的再来在哪儿呢？
Ever since our fathers died, everything goes on as it has from the beginning of creation.
自从我们的先祖睡了以后，那一切都像创世以前一样。
Now, I don't think any of us here would actually scoff about Jesus' coming or not coming yet.
我想在座的我们大概不会这样讥诮说，耶稣是会来还是不会再来。
But in our attitude, where we lack anticipation and expectation,
但是在我们的态度上，我们缺少这样一种期望。
We lack a sense of reverence, for His coming.
我们缺少这样一种对他再来而产生的敬畏。
As a result, we're not ready.
因此我们就没有预备好。
We're not motivated to live a holy life before Him, to share the gospel with those who are going to be under His wrath.
所以我们就没有说是要预备好过一个敬虔的生活，要去传扬福音，为他的再来做好准备。
I think it's helpful for us to be reminded of what Peter continues to say in 2 Peter 3.
所以这里，我们在看彼得的提醒，对我们很有帮助。
Verses 8 and 9. But do not forget this one thing, dear friends. With the Lord, a day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years are like a day. The Lord is not slow in keeping his promise, as some understand slowness. He is patient with you, not wanting anyone to perish, but everyone to come to repentance.
这里彼得说，亲爱的弟兄啊，有一件事你们不可忘记，就是主看一日如千年，千年如一日。主所应许的尚未成就，有人以为他是单言，其实不是单言，乃是宽容你们，不愿有一人沉沦，乃愿人人都悔改。
When Peter wrote this, it was less than a generation after Jesus' death and his promise to come again.
当彼得写这封书信的时候，他们还是在耶稣死了以后那一个世代。
For us, it's been over 2,000 years.
那对我们来说是已经经过超过2000年。
But if we use this illustration, a day is like 1,000 years. It's only been 2 days, right?
那如果我们照这个比喻，一日如千年的话，那就只过了2天而已。
Jesus's coming is still imminent.
那主耶稣的再来还是随时会发生的。
The promise is still there.
主的应许还是站立的。
He's patient, so more will come to know him, but the promise is there. We need to be expectant and anticipate his coming.
他是宽容我们，愿意更多的人悔改，但是我们应当有这样的期盼，盼望他再来。
So the first part of our handbook for Christian living is hope for living.
那我们基督徒生活手册的第一部分是生活的盼望。
The second part we're going to get into is direction for living. And let's read this passage first.
那第二部分是生活的指引。我们先来一起读。
First Thessalonians 5, verses 12 through 22.
帖撒罗尼迦前书5章12到22节。弟兄们，我们劝你们敬重那在你们中间劳苦的人，就是在主里面治理你们、劝诫你们的，又因他们所做的工，又爱心。用爱心格外尊重他们，你们也要彼此和睦。我们又劝弟兄们要警戒不守规矩的人，勉励灰心的人，扶助软弱的人，也要向众人忍耐。你们要谨慎，无论是谁，都不可以恶报恶，或是彼此相待，或是待众人，常要追求良善。
Verse 12 altogether.Now we ask you, brothers, to respect those who work hard among you, who are over you in the Lord, and who admonish you. Hold them in highest regard in love because of their work. Live in peace with each other. And we urge you, brothers, warn those who are unruly. Encourage the timid. Help the weak. Be patient with everyone. Make sure that nobody pays back wrong for wrong, but always try to be kind to each other and everyone else.
要常常喜乐，不住的祷告，凡事谢恩，因为这是神在基督耶稣里向你们所定的旨意。不要消灭圣灵的感动，不要藐视先知的讲论，但要凡事查验，善美的要持守，各样的恶事要禁戒不做。
Verse 16, be joyful always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Do not quench the Spirit, do not treat prophecies with contempt. Test everything, hold on to the good, avoid every kind of evil. In this section, Paul gives us directions for Christian living.
在这一部分，保罗给我们基督徒生活的指引。
Particularly how we experience godly relationships in the Church of Jesus Christ.
特别是怎么样在主的教会之中有一个，有一个敬虔的关系。
But all of this is really based on what we just saw. This section on hope for living gives us motivation to follow these directions.
这个都是基于上一个部分，就是生活的盼望，在这个基础上我们应当怎样生活。
Our assurance of Jesus coming, our expectation of seeing him and being with him forever give us motivation to follow these directions.
那我们知道耶稣随时要回来，我们也热切盼望他的回来，这就给了我们动力，要过怎么样的生活。
Now, as we've seen in the first four chapters of 1 Thessalonians, the Thessalonian church was actually doing pretty well.
我们从帖撒罗尼迦前书一到四章，我们可以看到帖撒罗尼迦教会实际上做得很不错。
Paul didn't have to deal with any major sins or concerns.
那保罗不需要来来处理什么些重大的罪的问题或者别的问题。
But Paul encourages them to excel still more.
但是保罗鼓励他们更加的被建造起来。
He encourages them that they're in a sanctification process.
他们是走在成圣的道路上。
And there's room for additional growth.
还有上升的空间。
So the directions given in this section will help them to move forward in this sanctification process.
所以在这一部分，保罗给出生活的指引，可以帮助他们在成圣的路上走得更远。
So there are three major sections here in this passage.
在这里有三个主要的部分。
Paul gives specific instructions related to specific groups of people.
那保罗给出这些具体的指示，是教导是给不同的人群。
He also then gives directions for maintaining our inner spiritual life.
他同时也指引我们怎么样，我们在内在的，这样的属灵的生活能够保持与主同行。
And then he gives directions for public worship.
然后他又给出，公共，一起敬拜的一些指导。
So let's take a look at this section.
那我们一起来看。
Specific groups of people.
那是教会中特定的人群。
In chapter 5, verses 12 through 15.
是从12到15节。
It talks about several different groups of people here.
有几种不同的人群。
The first one, he talks about those who are over you in the Lord.
第一个是在主里治理的人。
Says that we should respect them.
那说我们要敬重他们。
We should hold them in the highest regard in love.
我们又用在爱心里格外尊重他们。
Because of their work.
是因为他们在主里做工。
We should live in peace with each other.
我们也要彼此和睦。
Hebrews chapter 13 verse 17 also talks on this topic.
那希伯来书也讲到这一点。
Obey your leaders and submit to their authority.
你要顺服 执政掌权的。
They keep watch over you as men who must give an account.
他们是要必须向掌权的交账的。
Obey them so that their work will be a joy.
所以你们要顺服他们，使他们的使他们所做的工是有喜乐的。
And not a burden.
不是一个大的负担。
Because that would be no advantage for you.
那对你没有好处。
I like that last phrase.
我喜欢最后这一节。
The second group of people that Paul addresses here are those who are unruly.
那第二组人群，保罗所提到的是那些不守规矩的人。
Those who are undisciplined.
那些是不受管教的。
A lot of English translations say those who are idle.
那也有人说是那些闲散的人，有英文的翻译是这样讲。
How should we respond to them? We should warn them. We should admonish them.
我们应当怎么样对待他们呢？我们应当警告他们，警戒他们。
We should teach them the truth.
我们要将真理教导给他们。
In the next book of Thessalonians, 2 Thessalonians 3:11.
那在下一卷书《帖撒罗尼迦后书》第三章。
We saw that this was an issue in the Thessalonian church. He says, For we hear that some among you are leading a disorderly life, doing no work at all, but acting like busybodies.
那专门提到这个问题是说，在你们中间有不按规矩做的人，而是是闲散的人。
Now I don't think anybody in Emmanuel Church is unruly.
那我想在以马内利教会没有这样不守规矩的人。
But if Somebody were.
有人是这样。
We are called to admonish them in the Lord.
No, 我们的教导是要警戒他们。
To warn them that they turn around to the right way.
是要来教导他们要离弃错误的道路。
The next group of people that Paul addresses are those who are timid.
那下一组人是灰心的人。
Those who are fearful.
那些是心里有恐惧的人。
And we're to encourage them.
我们是要勉励他们。
We're to lift them up and come alongside and encourage them in the Lord.
是要扶助他们，扶持他们，在主里与他们同行。
Because in 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7,
在提摩太后书
Chapter 1, verse 7, it says, God did not give us a spirit of timidity, but of a spirit of power, of love, and self-discipline.
那说到神给我们不是惧怕的心，而是在主里面刚强，是刚强持守的心。
We may have people in our midst who are timid, who are fearful.
那我们中间也许有这样灰心、恐惧的、害怕的人。
We need to come alongside them and give them godly encouragement.
我们应当在他们身边来给他们这样的指引这样的鼓励。
The next group of people that Paul addresses are those who are weak.
那下一个人群是那些软弱的人。
Those who are strengthless.
那些无力的人。
Those who are physically, spiritually, morally weak.
那可能是身体上，或者是属灵上，或者是道德上的软弱。
And it says that we are to help them.
我们是要帮助扶助他们。
We're to hold them up firmly.
我们要把他们要有力的把他们扶起来。
And he goes on to say that we need to be patient with everyone.
最后又说到我们要向众人忍耐。
Sometimes it's hard to be patient with those who are unruly.
那有的时候对那些不守规矩的人很难忍耐。
Sometimes it's hard to be patient with those who are fearful and timid.
那些对于那些灰心害怕的人很难对他们忍耐。
Sometimes it's hard to be patient with those who are weak and lagging behind.
对那些软弱落后的人有时也很难忍耐。
We need to be patient with everyone.
我们要对众人忍耐。
Another possible group here that Paul addresses are those who pay back wrong for wrong.
那下一组是那些以恶报恶的人。
Those who are vindictive, who pay back evil for evil.
那些就是是必有 有怨必报的人，他们要以恶报恶。
Who try to take matters into their own hands, to bring about their own justice.
他们要把啊要把事情都掌握在自己手中，要自己来伸张正义。
But we are told to make sure no one pays back wrong for wrong, but always try to be kind to each other and to everyone else.
那这里教导我们都不可以以恶报恶，要彼此相待，是要追求良善。
Paul earnestly desired that the Thessalonians know how to adequately deal with people in every category.
所以保罗写信给帖撒罗尼迦教会，希望他们能够知道怎样跟不同的人群来相处。
And I think God earnestly desires that we at Emmanuel Church also learn how to deal adequately with people in every category.
我想这也是神对我们以马内利教会的心意，让我们知道如何能够信心充足地跟不同的人来交往。
That the entire church can be built up and strengthened.
这样我们全教会就能够被建立起来，被建造起来。
Then Paul goes in another direction, very, very important.
那下面保罗又向另一个方向来讲，也是很重要的。
Because all of these things that he's talked about, if our inner spiritual lives are weak, we cannot stand firm.
那我们上面讲的各种人际的关系，但是如果我们内在的属灵生命没有建造的话，那我们就做不到。
So he talks about three aspects that every believer needs to be concerned about in building strong spiritual foundations.
那你讲到怎样建立这样一个有力的属灵的根基，有三个方面。
First of all, he says that we need to be joyful always.
那第一个是讲要常常喜乐。
Joy is so important.
喜乐是如此重要。
We need to rejoice in the Lord always. Say it again, rejoice.
像保罗说，我们要在主里常常喜乐。我再说要喜乐。
In Philippians chapter 4, verse 4.
这是腓立比书四章四节。
We need to build that joy in our hearts. Allow God to increase that joy. We need to be joyful always.
我们要把这个心里的喜乐让它成长起来，所以我们要常常喜乐。
That word always kind of adds another spin to it. It's easy to be joyful when things are going well.
但是这里面这个常常就把它增添了一个难度。我们有时事情好的时候，我们喜乐不难。
But as a believer, we need to be joyful in every circumstance.
但是作为信徒，我们在无论在何等境遇之中，我们都当喜乐。
Because we don't live under our circumstances.
因为我们不是生活，我们不是受我们的境遇的控制。
We live in the joy of the Lord.
我们是在主的喜乐中生活。
Next, Paul says that we need to pray continually.
那下一条，保罗说我们要不住的祷告。
We need to pray at all times.
我们要随时的祷告。
Doesn't mean that 24/7 we're closing our eyes in prayer.
并不是说一天二十四小时我们都闭着眼睛在祷告。
But we always have this attitude of dependence on God, this attitude of seeking the Lord and coming into His presence.
那我们但是要随时有这种活在主的同在之中来寻求他有这样的一种心。
Ephesians chapter 6 verse 18.
以弗所书
Chapter 6, verse 18.
六章十八节。
It says, and pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the saints.
所以要靠着圣灵随时多方祷告祈求，并要在此警醒不倦，为众圣徒祈求。
And then the third one is to give thanks in all circumstances.
那第三点是凡事谢恩。
If it just said give thanks, it would be easier. But it says give thanks in all circumstances.
如果只是说谢恩，这容易，但是这讲要凡事谢恩。
In Ephesians chapter 5, verse 20.
那以弗所书第五章。
5, verse 20.
第五章二十节。
It says, always giving thanks to God the Father for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
那么凡事要奉我们主耶稣基督的名，常常感谢父神。
And we can do that because of Romans 8:28. We know that in all things God works together for good for those who love Him and are called according to His purposes.
那我们能够这样谢恩，是因为在罗马书八章二十八节说，那是罗马书八章二十八节是说。我们晓得万事互相效力，叫爱神的人得益处，就是按他旨意被召，预先定下效法他儿子的模样。
There's a little small but important fact. It says, "Give thanks in all circumstances, not give thanks for all circumstances."
这里英文是讲在我们要在各种的境况之下都谢恩，并不是说为各样的境况来谢恩。
There's some things that aren't really that wonderful that happen in our lives.
那有些在我们生活中发生的事情并不好。
But we can give thanks in those things because we know that God is in control.
可是在那样的境遇之中，我们还是可以谢恩，因为我们知道神是掌权的。
And this next phrase, it's connected to verse 18, give thanks in all circumstances, but I think it applies to all three.
那下一条是和凡事谢恩相连的，但是我想跟前面三条其实都是相连的。
This is God's will for you in Christ Jesus.
因为这是神在基督耶稣里向你们所定的旨意。
This is God's will for you.
这是神的旨意。
There's one other thing that we talked about when Brother Chung Dao was sharing on chapter 4 that is God's will for us.
那还有一件事就是中道弟兄在第四章向我们分享的。
And that is, it is God's will for you that you should be sanctified, that you should avoid sexual immorality.
说这是神的旨意，你们应当不要放纵肉体的情欲，是要过圣洁的生活。
Whenever we hear something in the Bible that says this is God's will for us, we should pay close attention to it.
任何时候我们在圣经里读到这是神的旨意，我们就应当特别的注意。
And it is God's will for us to be joyful always, to pray continually, and to give thanks in all circumstances.
那这是神的旨意，要常常喜乐，不住的祷告，凡事谢恩。
In the final part of this section,
那在这一部分的最后一节，
He gives directions for public worship.
是关于公共礼拜的指示。
In verse 19, he says, "Do not quench the Spirit."
十九节说，不要消灭圣灵的感动。
The fire of the Holy Spirit in our lives should not be doused with sin.
那圣灵在我们生活之中的感动，不应当被罪所消灭。
A similar phrase in Ephesians 4:30 is "Do not grieve the Holy Spirit."
就像以弗所书四章二十节说，不要使圣灵担忧。
The Holy Spirit was given to live inside us, to direct us, to empower us, to teach us.
圣灵在我们心里边内住，是来教导我们，是来指引我们，是给我们力量。
We need to be sensitive to His leading and follow Him, and not quench the Holy Spirit.
我们应当敏感于圣灵的指导，而不是消灭圣灵的感动。
The second admonition, the second direction for public worship is do not treat prophecies with contempt.
那第二点指示是说不要藐视先知的讲论。
It seems that the church in Thessalonica, similar to the church in Corinth, underrated the gift of prophecy. Underrated the gift of prophecy.
那帖撒罗尼迦教会像哥林多教会一样，他们对保罗所给的他们对保罗所给的这个先知的这样的言论，他们不是太清楚。
Says that when Paul preached the gospel to them, they accepted it as it were the word of God. And they allowed God to use it in their lives, but they're apparently not having the same attitude toward others who are sharing God's word with them.
当他们听到保罗传向他们传讲福音，他们当作神的话语而接受，但是他们对其他人所对他们的教导就不是同样的态度。
I think we already know this, but it might be a good reminder that prophecy is not just foretelling the future.
这点我们可能知道，但是还是值得再一次提醒。这里说到先知的讲论，并不是单指预言未来发生的事情。
Prophecy is foretelling the truth of God.
那先知的讲论是讲出神的真理。
And apparently the Thessalonian Christians were having trouble in acknowledging that the words of their leaders, those that were speaking God's word to them, was valid.
那很明显，帖撒罗尼迦教会他们对这些对他们所讲论神的话语，这些不是保罗的这些同工对他们讲的，他们有一些保留。
So actually, this passage could read, "Stop treating prophecies with contempt."
这里也可以这样来理解，就是不要来，不要藐视先知的讲论。中文翻译比较准确。
Now we see, do not quench the spirit, do not treat prophecies with contempt. To balance that out, he says, "Test everything."
那前面讲到不要消灭圣灵的感动，不要藐视先知的讲论。那和这个相平衡的又讲到要凡事查验。
We don't quench the spirit, we don't treat prophecies with contempt, but we also need to test the spirits. We need to test to make sure that they are from God.
我们不消灭圣灵的感动，不藐视先知的讲论，但是我们要凡事查验，来查验是否出于神。
All manifestations of the Spirit should be tested.
所有这个属灵的这种彰显，我们都要来查验。
In 1 John chapter 4, verse 1.
在彼得前书三章一节。
First John, 约翰。
约翰。约翰一书三章一节。
He says, "Dear friends, do not believe every spirit, but test the spirits to see whether they are from God, because many false prophets have gone out into the world."
那说到弟兄们啊，一切的灵你们不要都信，因为有你们总要查验，因为已经有那些敌基督的灵在世上。
So we need to test the spirits. That which is valid, we should accept. That which is invalid, we should disallow.
所以我们要凡事查验，那些是正当的，我们当接受；那些是不是属神的，我们要拒绝。
And it seems that the next two points relate to that.
那下面两点是和这个相连的。
As we test everything, we should hold on to the good.
当我们查验之后，那美善的我们要持守。
We should avoid every kind of evil.
那些恶事我们要远离，要禁戒。
好， we're almost done. Stick with me, brothers and sisters.
弟兄姐妹，我们快要结束。
But finally, we have a conclusion.
那最后有一个结论。
Let's just read these few verses here.
我们把这几节读一下。
Nice, would you start with verse?
Okay. 愿赐平安的神亲自使你们全然成圣，又愿你们的灵与魂与身子得蒙保守，在我主耶稣基督降临的时候完全无可指摘。那召你们的本是信实的，他必成就这事。请弟兄们为我们祷告，与众弟兄亲嘴问安，务要圣洁。我指着主嘱咐你们，要把这信念给众弟兄听。愿我主耶稣基督的恩常与你们同在。
Verse 23 altogether, may God Himself, the God of peace, sanctify you through and through. May your whole spirit, soul, and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, He will do it. Brothers, pray for us. Greet all the brothers with a holy kiss. I charge you before the Lord to have this letter read to all of the brothers. Grace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Amen. Amen. Just a few highlights here. I'm not going to get into a lot of detail.
我不会有讲很多细节,
但有几个重点。 But it starts out with a very encouraging, a very blessed benediction prayer.
这一个很丰富的一个祝福。
He says, May the God of peace sanctify you through and through.
说愿赐平安的神亲自使你们全然成圣。
The God of peace.
赐平安的神。
The God who gives peace internally, the God who gives peace in the body of Christ.
那是赐主的身体平安，赐我们心里的平安的神。
May he sanctify you through and through.
使你全然的成圣。
Sanctification is a huge theme in this book.
那成圣是一个这本书的重大的一个主题。
May your whole spirit, soul, and body be kept blameless.
使你的灵魂与身子得蒙保守。
The sanctification is through and through. It includes all every part of us, our soul, our spirit, our body.
这个成圣是一个全然，是从里到外全部全人的，包括了我们的灵魂与身体。
Be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ.
使我们可以在主再来的时候无可指摘。
The coming of Jesus is also a huge theme in this book.
那主的再来也是这本书的一个重要的主题。
Not just the sections that we studied earlier, but every chapter ends with an admonition that Jesus is coming.
不光是我们今天读到的这一部分，几乎每一章里面都以主的再来来结束。
Wants them to anticipate and be ready for his coming.
是鼓励信徒们能够预备好，能够期待盼望主的再来。
Let me move on to salutations.
然后后面是寒暄。
There's several things I won't really get into much detail at all. But the one who calls you is faithful, he will do it.
这里讲到那招你们的是信实的。
An assurance that our God is faithful, what he promised, he will do.
这是这样一个提醒，那主是信实的，他所应许的，他必要成就。
A request for them to pray for him.
然后说请弟兄们为他们祷告。
That a request for them to greet one another with a holy kiss.
说要彼此以一个圣洁的吻来亲嘴问安。
Now that sounds kind of strange to us.
这对我们来说听起来好像有点怪怪。
But it was a strong cultural greeting.
那是在当时是他们的文化背景之下这样的一个问候。
And greeting each other with a holy kiss is actually mentioned 5 times in the New Testament.
这样以一个圣洁的 这样的一个亲吻来亲嘴问安，在新约里面出现过5次。
There are still several cultures today that greet each other with a holy kiss.
那即使在今日，实际上有些文化之中还是这样用亲嘴来问安。
And then a request for them, actually not just a request, but I charge you to have this letter read to all the brothers.
那下面是个是嘱咐，我指着主。 嘱咐你们要把这信念给弟兄们，众弟兄听。
And then another short but powerful benediction, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
那最后是一个简短但有力的祝福，是说愿我主耶稣基督的恩常与你们同在。
As we close, I just want to show this diagram one more time.
到结束之前，我想把这个图片再
Paul presents in this passage for us a handbook for Christian living.
那在这一段书信里面，保罗是呈现给我们的是一个基督徒的生活手册。
Let's take a moment silently to look over this handbook for Christian living outline.
那让我们安静几分钟的时间，我们把这个看一遍。
Those areas that you feel you need to grow in, ask God for grace to grow.
如果你觉得有哪些 地方是你需要成长的，你就求主给你恩典，让你可以成长。
Do you have this sense of anticipation and excitement for the coming of Jesus?
让我们有这样的一种紧急感、紧迫感，这样一种对主再来的盼望。
Are there groups of people in our church that you really haven't been dealing with adequately?
是不是有些在教会之中特定的人群，你需要来学习怎样与他们相处？
How about our inner life? Are we rejoicing always, praying without ceasing, and in everything giving thanks?
还有我们内在的属灵的生活，我们是不是常常喜乐？是不是不住祷告？是不是凡事谢恩？
Are we quenching the spirit? Are we forsaking the gift of prophecy?
我们是不是有没有消灭圣灵的感动？有没有藐视先知的讲论？
Just take a moment or two silently to look over this list and come before the Lord. Lay bare your heart to Him and let Him come and give you guidance and direction.
让我们花一点安静的时间，到主的面前，请他给你指示。
In just a moment, I'll close.
那过一会儿我会做结束。
Lord, we thank you for your wonderful word.
主，为你奇妙的话语感谢你。
Thank you for speaking to us today.
谢谢你今天向我们讲话。
You've heard the cries of our heart.
你听到我们心里的呼求。
Our need for you to work in our lives.
我们需要你在我们生命中做工。
We ask that you will work.
求你来做。
That you will continue to equip us and use us as we continue to walk with you and serve you.
当我们与你同行来服侍你的时候，求你在我们身上做工。
We love you.
我们爱你。
We pray all this in Jesus' name.
我们这样祷告是奉主耶稣的名。
Amen.
Amen.